Travis Nix is joining me today. He is a law student at Georgetown University and is speaking out against his school's COVID-19 protocols. Travis, thanks so much for joining me today.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me on.
Of course. So tell us, what is going on at Georgetown University and what protocols are they putting in place that you're against?
Yeah, so basically we just got an email out of the blue last week, and basically for any student who has a medical exemption, they are forcing them to get COVID tested twice a week, go through all these daily health screenings, recommending that they socially distance inside the classroom. And basically, if they don't follow these protocols, they will not be able to attend class. There's no online option for students with medical exemptions, to my knowledge.
Wow. I mean, what are they supposed to do then? Do they just drop out of the university?
Yeah. So basically, for students who are unvaccinated without a medical exemption, it's a functional equivalent of an expulsion. The registrar is making them withdraw from all of their classes for the unvaccinated who don't have a medical or religious exemption. For the people who do have an exemptions, it's not quite as harsh, but if you don't follow these protocols, then it's going to be the same thing. Mm-hmm. The functional equivalent of an expulsion, because you cannot attend class and you cannot learn.
Something that you also brought up in this article that you wrote for the Washington Examiner is that people who are exempt from getting the vaccine have to test 2 times per week and also have a daily check-in survey for COVID-19. What message do you have for the administrators, and do you think this could potentially change?
Yeah, the administration really needs to think about the consequences of these policies. Mm-hmm. As someone who has an immune deficiency, I strongly relate to people who do have medical exemptions. I personally don't have one. But I mean, it's going to be very embarrassing for them, in my opinion, to right after class go down to get tested, because that takes them away from having conversations with their classmates after class to discuss, you know, all the interesting cases that we're reading. Takes them away from the professors, and everyone can see them get tested. So basically, everyone's going to just be labeled either a conspiracy theorist and an anti-vaxxer, or everyone's going to know they have a medical condition. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's taken me a long time to be able to speak openly about my condition. No one should be put into that situation before they are ready. And students are going to be forced to disclose their medical condition to the other classmates when they're prompted, because they're not going to want to look like an anti-vaxxer if they're not. Administration has really lost the trust of the student body, in my opinion, with their COVID protocols, because they flip-flopped since the beginning of the pandemic. Mm-hmm. And when the pandemic started, they said we were going to have grades, and they took the grades away. Then in the summer of 2020, the message was, we're going to be in person. And then 2 weeks before class starts, they pulled the plug on in-person classes. So, I mean, I only had one in-person class for my first year of law school. And then, like, going into the spring of 2021, earlier this year, it seemed like, you know, we are going to be fully in person with no restrictions. And then they come out again with mass mandates and, in my opinion, discriminatory policies for people with medical condition exemptions that single them out. So I don't think there's been any consistency by the administration, and they frankly don't have my trust.
You know, obviously you got the vaccine. You are among some of the more vulnerable people in our population. Now we're being told to wear masks. Now we're telling, the administration is telling people and the CDC kind of to go back to what we thought we would, you know, not have to do anymore when people got vaccinated. So do you feel safe that you have the vaccine?
So actually the vaccine didn't work on me, sadly.
Oh no.
So less safe than we hoped for. It was very unlikely that the vaccine was gonna work, but we still tried it and it just didn't work. I think the most damaging thing about the administration flip-flopping on masks is it just creates another incentive for people not to get vaccinated. Mm-hmm. Because the whole incentive was, get vaccinated, you won't have to wear a mask. And that puts people like me in danger, because mm-hmm. the more people that are vaccinated, the better. Because that's what's eventually going to keep me safe, is healthy people getting vaccinated. And so just create another disincentive against the vaccinations. It's very problematic for my community.
Can you actually talk a little bit more about how the vaccine didn't work for you? I know in your article you write how, you know, you got the vaccine and sometimes it could work, sometimes it couldn't. Obviously in this case, it didn't work. So what about your condition sort of, I guess, clashed with the vaccine?
Yeah, my immunologists were very skeptical that it was going to work on me, but they figured we should try it because it might create like a good T cell response, which is very possible, and like a cellular response. But so my specific condition makes me unable to produce B cells and antibodies. So therefore, I just metabolize any antibody that's being produced in my body extremely fast. So I just didn't have any type of antibody response to the vaccine.
In terms of a response from peers and professors, what have they been saying? Are they on board with it? Are they against it?
It's been about 50-50. I think a large majority of the student body thinks that these protocols are too extreme. However, they still think there should be protocols, which might be a little different from my opinion, but so yeah, it's been mixed.
And what we've been talking about is that you're against these COVID-19 protocols going on at your school. Are there any sort of protocols that you would support to be implemented at Georgetown University?
I think like a vaccine mandate, obviously they're a private university, they can do that. I think there's a debate of whether they should be doing that with a new vaccine, because some people might feel uncomfortable with that. But I think that like that's a protocol that that they should be encouraged vaccinations. I don't think the unvaccinated is a big problem at Georgetown Law. I think our student body is probably at least 95% vaccinated. So I'm not sure it's a necessary protocol, because I think Georgetown students would have gotten vaccinated anyway based on the demographics of Georgetown Law students. But no, that's like a fine protocol. But I'm very against singling out the medically exempt and the religious exempt.
Travis Nix, thank you so much for joining me today. It is always great to see you. I appreciate you coming on and talking about these COVID-19 protocols going on at Georgetown University. Have a great day, and I'm sure I'll see you again soon. Thank you.
Thanks so much for having me.